Venous admixture is a phenomenon where deoxygenated venous blood mixes with oxygen-rich arterial blood from the pulmonary circulation. This results in the delivery of blood with lower oxygen content to the systemic circulation than would be expected if there was no mixing. We created this video to cover the medical definition and provide a brief overview of this topic. So if you're ready, let's get into it. In a healthy individual, blood with low oxygen content flows from the right side of the heart to the lungs, where it picks up oxygen from the inhaled air and releases carbon dioxide. The oxygenated blood then returns to the left side of the heart, from where it is pumped into the systemic circulation to supply the body's tissues with oxygen. Venous admixture occurs when there are anatomical or functional abnormalities in the pulmonary circulation that allow deoxygenated blood to bypass the lungs and mix with oxygenated blood. This could be due to a variety of causes, including ventilation-perfusion mismatch, intracardiac or intrapulmonary shunts, or lung diseases that compromise the oxygenation process. Congestive heart failure with low cardiac output is another common cause, which is typically related to some type of VQ mismatch. CHF impairs the heart's ability to pump blood effectively, leading to fluid accumulation in the lungs and other areas of the body. This fluid accumulation can cause several changes in the lungs, such as impaired gas exchange, hypoxemic vasoconstriction, and increased pulmonary capillary pressures. These factors combine to promote venous admixture in CHF patients, resulting in hypoxemia and decreased arterial oxygenation. Treatment strategies for CHF typically focus on improving cardiac function, reducing fluid accumulation, and alleviating symptoms, which can help mitigate the impact of venous admixture in these patients. Increased venous admixture leads to a reduction in the overall oxygen content of the arterial blood, which may contribute to hypoxemia or low blood oxygen levels. This is clinically significant, particularly in patients with pre-existing respiratory or cardiovascular diseases, and requires further investigation and treatment. If you want to support the channel, please like and subscribe. I would greatly appreciate it. And there should be some other helpful videos popping up on your screen right about now that I think you will enjoy. And just a quick reminder, we are not doctors. This video is for informational purposes only. Thank you so much for watching. Have a blessed day. And as always, breathe easy, my friends.